So, Rhythm, yeah, so this is a story. Okay. So, Rhythm, can you start by reading the story if you can see the screen?
Once upon a time, there was a huge apple tree. A little boy used to come to play near the tree. He would search for juicy apples. He would play alongside the tree and rest under the shade. The tree was overjoyed after meeting this little bundle of joy. One day, the tree was surprised to see that boy approaching it with a sad face. "Come on, boy, play with me," the tree asked the boy. "I'm no longer a kid to play around the tree like you." The boy scowled at the tree. "I need toys. I need money to buy toys of various designs and sizes," the boy told the tree. "I'm sorry, my dear boy. I do not have the money to give you, but you can pick my apples and sell them. That will give you adequate amount of money to buy toys of your choices," replied the tree in a soothing voice. The boy grabbed the apples. The boy grabbed the apples and left happily. He sold the apples and got money. He bought
Okay.
toys of his choices. Spring bid adieu, and autumn came by, but there was no sign of the boy. One
Okay.
morning, the tree saw its friend. The little boy had grown up into a big man. "Come and play with me," the tree said. "I cannot play. I have a family now. We need the tree for
We need a
shelter."
house. We need a house for shelters.
Sorry, "we need a house for shelter. Can you help me?" The man replied, "Sorry, I do not have a house, but you can chop off my branches and build your house," the
Yes.
tree told the man. The
Okay.
man cut all the branches of the tree and left happily. The tree was glad to see his friend smiling again. The man returned one evening to the apple tree. "Come
Okay.
and play with me," the tree asked the man. "I'm getting old. I want to go sailing to relax myself. Can you give me a boat?" the man asked the apple tree. "Use my trunk to build your boat," the tree told the man.
Bad. Okay.
He cut off the trunk and made a boat out of it. He went smiling and never
He
showed
went
up for a long time.
rhythm is he went sailing. He went sailing.
Sorry, he went sailing and never showed up for a long time. The
Okay.
man returned after many years. "Sorry, my boy,
Do not have.
but now I do not have anything to offer you. I have nothing for you anymore. No apples, no branches, no more trunks for you to climb on," the tree said with its pained voice. "No problem. I do not have teeth to bite. I am too old to climb trees," the man replied. "I just need a place to rest after these days," the man replied. "Old tree roots are the best place to lean on. Come on, sit with me and rest," the apple tree replied with this concern in its tone,
It's
in
voice.
its voice.
The old man.
The old man sat down. The apple tree was glad and smiled with tears. This is a story of every person. The tree is like our parents. When we were young, we could not have imagined our life without them. But as we grew up, we leave them. No matter what, parents will always be happy and give us everything to make us happy.
Yes, it's such a great story. Okay, it's such an inspiring story. Okay, so great rhythm. You have read very well. Okay, so now, okay, so just a minute, Rishika. So I think, okay, Nishtha, can you hear me now? Hello, Nishtha, can you just speak something so that we can say if your voice is coming? Nishtha, can you introduce yourself? Hello?
Ma'am,
Yeah, Rishika, yes. So Nishtha, can you hear me? Because your voice is not coming, Vijay. Okay. Okay, so Rishika, it's now your turn. Okay, you can start reading the story. Okay, so then I will tell you what you will do. Okay?
Ma'am, from the start, right?
Yeah. I think you have understood the story now, so you can read it in a very good way.
Once upon a time, there was a huge apple tree. Okay. A little boy used to come and play near the tree. Hmm. He would search for juicy apples. He would play alongside the tree and rest under the shade. The tree was overjoyed after meeting this little bundle of joy. Hmm. One day, the tree was surprised to see the boy approaching it with a sad face. Hmm. Come on, little boy, play with me, the tree asked the boy.
Okay.
I am no longer a kid to play around tree like you. Hmm. The boy scowled at the tree. I need toys. I need money to buy toys of various designs and sizes, the boy told the tree. Sorry, my dear boy, I do not have the money to give to give you. But you can pick all my apples and sell them. That will give you adequate money to buy toys of your choices, replied the tree in a soothing voice. The boy grabbed all the apples and left happily. He sold the apples and got the money. He bought toys of his choice. Spring withered dew and autumn came by. There was no sign of the boy.
Okay.
One morning, the tree saw its friend. That little boy had grown up into a big man.
Okay. Okay, yeah.
Yes.
Okay, so I'll highlight the part so that you don't get confused, okay? Yeah. Yes, Rishika.
Come and play with me, the tree said. I cannot play. I have a family now.
Okay.
We need a house for shelters. Can you help me? The man replied. Sorry, I do not have a house. But you can chop off my branches to build your house, the tree told the man.
Okay.
The man cut all the branches of the tree and left happily. Tree was glad to see his friend smiling again.
The man returned. Yeah.
Man returned one evening to the apple tree. Come and play with me, the tree asked the man. I'm getting old. I want to go sailing to relax myself. Okay. Can you give me a boat? The man asked the apple tree. Use my trunk to build your boat, the tree told the man. He cut off the trunk and made a boat out of it.
Yeah.
He went sailing, and never showed up for a long time. The man returned after many years. Sorry, my boy, but now I do not have anything to offer to you. I have nothing for you anymore. No more apples, no more branches, no more trunks for you to climb on, the tree said with a pain in his voice. No problem. I too do not have any teeth to bite, and I am too old to climb trees, the man replied. I just need a place to rest after all these days, the man replied. Old roots are the best place to lean on. Come and sit down.
Sit down with me and rest.
Come on, sit down with me and rest. The apple tree replied with a concern in its voice. The old man sat down. The apple tree was glad and smiled with tears. This is the story of every person. The tree is like our parents. When we were young, we could not have imagined our life without them.
Exactly.
As we grow up, we leave.
We leave them.
What parents will always be there and give us everything to make us happy.
Yes, exactly. So now, Rishika Ridham, I think you are very much clear about the story. Okay. So now I will tell you a few words. But before that, so what will I do today? So Rishika Ridham, so now you have to write this story in your own words. So see, in this the story, they are having a dialogues. So you can skip the dialogues, okay? So now what you have to do both, you can, you know, just recreate the story in a single paragraph, in a smaller version, the version of yourself. Like suppose you have any younger sibling at the home and you want to say the same story. So how will you recreate the same story in a different
summary writer?
Yeah, exactly. You can write the summary, okay? You can skip that dialogue part. You can skip something like which is not relevant, okay? So you have to write in a single short way, okay? And after writing, Rhythm and Rishika, You can, you know, send the pictures to me. You have to send the pictures to me, okay? So that I can check if there is some spelling mistake or not, okay? So Rishika, I understood, bachche, yes or no? So Rishika, can you hear me? Rishika, are you there? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So Ritham, yes, bachche, you too. After writing, you can send the picture to me, okay? So that I can check if there is some spelling mistake or not. So yeah, Nishtha. So Nishtha, can you try to speak something now?
Ma'am, can you hear me now?
Yeah, I can hear you now. Yeah, so Nishtha, great. So Nishtha, just introduce yourself a little bit.
My name is Nishtha. I study in class 8. I'm okay. From Punjab.
Oh, wow. Okay. Yes, go ahead. So what is your hobby, Nishtha? What do you love to do in free time?
My hobby is to play basketball.
Okay, great. So where you belong basically from Punjab?
Ludhiana.
Okay, even I'm from Punjab. I belong to Amritsar, but now I'm staying in Gurgaon. Okay, so that's why I told you, wow. Okay, great. Okay, good. Okay, so Nishtha, what is the name of your school?
Sacred Heart Senior Secondary School.
Okay. So what is your hobby? You love to play badminton?
Basketball.
Okay, great. Okay, so apart from playing basketball, what do you love to do? Love any stories, reading stories or whatever?
Yeah, I like to read stories.
Okay, so which is your favorite story?
Currently, I'm reading Secret 7, which is really interesting.
Oh, wow, that's good. So what do you like about that book?
It's very mysterious.
Okay. So you're reading that?
Yes.
Okay, good. Very good. Okay. Okay, so Nishtha, did you hear the story which Rishika and Vidham has, read just now?
Yes, ma'am.
So, okay. So now it's your turn. So just try to read the story in the same way, okay? Yeah, so Nishtha, you can start with it.
Once upon a time, there was a huge apple tree. A little boy used to come to play near the tree. He would search for juicy apples. Okay. He would play alongside the tree and rest under the shade. Hmm. The tree was overjoyed after meeting this little bundle of joy. Hmm. One day, the tree was surprised to see that boy approaching it with a sad face. Hmm. Come on, little boy, play with me, the tree asked the boy.
Yes.
I'm no longer a kid to play around tree like you. The boy scowled at the tree.
Hmm.
I need toys. I need money to buy toys of various designs and sizes. Hmm. The boy told the tree, sorry, my dear boy, I do not have money to give you, but you can pick all the apples and sell them.
Hmm.
That will give you adequate money to buy toys of your choice, replied the tree in soothing voice. The boy grabbed all the apples and left happily. He sold the apples and got money. He bought toys of his choice. Spring bit adieu and autumn came by, but there was no sign of the boy. One morning, the tree saw its friend. That little boy had grown up into a man.
Okay.
Come on and play with me, the tree said. I cannot play. I have family now. I need a house for shelter. Can you help me? The man replied. Sorry, I don't have any house. But you can chop off my branches to build your house, the tree told. The man cut all his branches of the tree. And left happily. The tree was glad to see his friend smiling again. The man returned one evening to the apple tree. Come and play with me, the tree asked the man. I am getting old. I want to go sailing to relax myself. Can you give me a boat? The man asked the apple tree. Use my trunk to build your boat, the tree told the man. He cut off the trunk and made a boat out of it. He went sailing and never showed up for a long time. The man returned after many years. Sorry, my boy, but now I do not have anything to offer to you. I have nothing for you anymore. No more apples, no more branches, and no more trunks for you to climb on. The tree said with a pain in its voice. No problem. I told do not have any teeth to bite, and I am too old to climb trees, the man replied. I just need a place to rest after all these days, the man replied. Old tree roots are the best place to lean on. Come on and sit down with me and rest. The apple tree replied with a concern in its voice. The old man sat down. The apple tree was glad and smiled with tears. This is a story of every person. The tree is like your parents. When we were young, we could not have imagined our life without them. But as we grow up, we leave them. No matter what, the parents will always
be there.
Be there and give us everything to make us happy.
Yeah, very good. Very well read. Okay. So, Rishta, very good. Okay, so Rishta, now I'm giving you bachche the same thing. So, now you have to recreate the story in a single paragraph, okay? So, see, this is a very long story, now. So, now I just request or recommend you can, you know, just try to write the summary of the story. You can skip that dialogue part, okay? Or which is unrelevant part, you can skip that, okay? Yeah, so you have the copy, Rishta, somewhere in... So, you can, okay, so you can start writing, okay? So, then we can do some vocabulary part.
Thomas, can you scroll up a little bit?
Sorry?
Can you scroll up a little bit?
Okay.
Okay, just sorry, down, minute. Down. Sorry, down.
Okay. Is it okay, Rhythm?
I'm okay. Yeah.
So, Rhythm, don't look at the screen, okay? Like, you don't have to create the same...
I just wanted to see what was after what.
Okay, okay, okay.
If you find any difficulty, you may ask, ma'am.
Yeah, so Rhythm, Rishika, Nishtha, if you have any question, you can ask me.
No, ma'am.
Okay.
Oh, ma'am, can you go down again?
Okay, just a minute. Yeah. Okay. So, Rhythm, is it fine?
Yeah.
Okay.